जरूरत नहीं है। हेलो एवरीवन, अगेन दिस इज विनायक। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टुडे इकोनॉमिक्स इकोनॉमिक्स फर्स्ट चैप्टर द विलेज ऑफ पालमपुर। सो बेसिकली इन दिस चैप्टर इट्स अ विलेज विच इज अ केस स्टडी फॉर अस टू लर्न मेनी थिंग्स, हाउ दे डेवलप, हाउ द डेवलपमेंट टेक्स ऑन। सो वी आर गोइंग टू टेक दिस केस स्टडी ऑफ विलेज पालमपुर एंड देन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ विलेज एंड वेरियस वेज ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज। नाउ फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू सी द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस लेसन। दिस विलेज, इन द विलेज फार्मिंग इज द मेन एक्टिविटी इन पालमपुर, वेर एज सेवरल अदर एक्टिविटीज सच एज स्मॉल स्केल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, डेयरी, ट्रांसपोर्ट एक्सेट्रा आर कैरीड ऑन ए लिमिटेड स्केल्स। दीज प्रोडक्शन एक्टिविटीज नीड वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ रिसोर्सेस। सो फॉर दिस व्हाट आर द रिसोर्सेस रिक्वायर्ड फॉर प्रोडक्शन ऑफ एनी एक्टिविटीज? वी नीड वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ रिसोर्सेस। द फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट एंड द मेजर रिक्वायरमेंट इज द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस, देन मैन मेड रिसोर्सेस, देन ह्यूमन एफर्ट, मनी एक्सेट्रा। मैन मेड इज अगेन मैन मेड रिसोर्सेस एंड देन ह्यूमन एफर्ट मीन्स द वर्क व्हाट दे आर गोइंग टू डू, ह्यूमंस, दैट इज व्हेन वी कॉल लेबर। लेबर कम्स अंडर ह्यूमन एफर्ट, और नाउडेज वी से ह्यूमन रिसोर्स। एंड मनी, मनी इज नथिंग बट द कैपिटल इन्वेस्टेड इन द एक्टिविटीज एक्सेट्रा। नाउ पालमपुर इज वेल कनेक्टेड विथ नेबरिंग विलेजेस एंड टाउन्स। रायगंज इज अ वेरी बिग विलेज विच इज 3 किलोमीटर्स अवे फ्रॉम पालमपुर, दैट इज रायगंज इज द नियरेस्ट विलेज फॉर पालमपुर विच इज 3 किलोमीटर्स अवे। एंड ऑल वेदर रोड कनेक्ट्स द विलेज टू रायगंज एंड फर्दर ऑन द नियरेस्ट स्मॉल टाउन ऑफ शाहपुर। एंड ऑल वेदर रोड मीन्स दे हैव ए वेल पक्का रोड, दैट इज बीटी रोड और अ पक्का रोड विच इज गुड फॉर ऑल द वेदर कंडीशंस लाइक रेनी सीजन, समर सीजन एंड ऑल। एंड इट इज कनेक्टिंग टू रायगंज एंड फर्दर ऑन टू द नियरेस्ट स्मॉल टाउन ऑफ शाहपुर। मेनी काइंड्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट आर विजिबल ऑन दिस रोड स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम बुलक कार्ट्स, टोंगास, बोगीज लोडेड विथ जैगरी एंड अदर कॉमोडिटीज टू मोटर व्हीकल्स लाइक मोटरसाइकल्स, जीप्स, ट्रैक्टर्स एंड ट्रक्स। नाउडेज वी ऑल्सो सी वेन वी गो टू द विलेज साइड वी सी ऑल दीज वेज ऑफ मीन्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट। ऑफकोर्स नाउडेज वी आर नॉट फाइंडिंग मच टोंगास और बगीज और बुलक कार्ट्स, फ्यू, वेरी फ्यू वी फाइंड। अबाउट द विलेज, सो वी आर गोइंग टू नो अबाउट द विलेज फर्स्ट। द विलेज हैज अबाउट 450 फैमिलीज बिलोंगिंग टू सेवरल डिफरेंट कास्ट। द विलेज हैज अबाउट 450 फैमिलीज बिलोंगिंग टू सेवरल डिफरेंट कास्ट। द अपर कास्ट फैमिलीज ओन द मेजॉरिटी ऑफ लैंड इन द विलेज। देर हाउसेस आर quite large and made of brick with cement plastering, and the scheduled caste, the lower caste They are almost one third of the population. They compel or they are more around one third of the population of the village and live in one corner of the village and in much smaller houses, some of which are made up of mud and straw. Straw means it comes from the grass. So grass thatched houses, what we call thatched houses or huts, like a larger size of huts. So these are the situation in the village. Electricity powers all the tube wells in the fields and is used in various types of small business. Palampur has two primary schools and one high school. There is a primary health center run by the government and one private dispensary where the sick are treated. Means we are getting an outlook of the village. What are the facilities they are there available in the village? Now, tube wells means they are the motors fitted with the pipeline, and then whatever the water source is there for it, it will be arranged in such a way that they need irrigational facilities, and then electricity power is needed for it. So this village is having well connected electrical power, so more tube wells are used in the fields and it is used in other small business also. And Palampur is having two primary schools and one high school, and even there is a government primary health center for the health facilities and health care of the villagers, and one private dispensary where the sick are treated, where the sick people are treated. Organization of production. Now we are going to know about what are the various organizations of production. The aim of production is to produce the goods and services that we want. There are four requirements for the production of goods and services. See, what is the aim? What is the goal of production? It is to produce goods and services that we require. So, what are those four requirements? The first requirement is land. Second requirement is labor. Third requirement is physical capital. So we shall learn one by one after the other. So again, physical capital is of two types. One is tools, machines, and building. So suppose in these requirements, whatever, if a producer or if a manufacturer wants to start any production unit like a small factory or an industry, basic requirements are, first he has to have a piece of land. Then the second requirement is labor. The third one is the physical capital. In the physical capital, again it is divided into two types. One is tools, machines, and buildings. Even in depth, if we go, we can call it as assets. Tools and machines range from very simple tools such as a farmer's plow to sophisticated machines such as generators, turbines, computers, etc. Tools, machines, buildings can be used in production over many years and are called fixed capital. We call it as fixed capital because they are the assets. They have some value and even it can be resold, but with little bit of depreciation. Depreciation means as time passes, after you use such some goods, so it will lose its value. For example, now if we buy a car or a automobile or a mobile phone or anything, after you use it, that model will be outdated, so its value will decrease. So that's why when we buy second hand goods, we get in a lesser price. The same way, even these tools, machines, buildings are used in production over many years, they can be used and are called fixed capital. Now next is raw materials and money in hand. Money in hand, or we can say cash in hand. Cash in hand. So production requires a variety of raw materials such as the yarn used by the weaver and the clay used by the potter. So this is a raw material for them. So yarn, thread, which is used by a weaver to manufacture a cloth. Cloth is the finished good, whereas yarn is the raw material. The same way clay is the raw material. After he prepares a pot, he manufactures a pot. Pot is the finished goods. Also some money is required during production to make payments and buy other necessary items. Raw material and money in hand are most important here. So now here we say that what is the raw material here required along with that cash in hand. Why we need cash in hand? For example, a garment manufacturing industry is there. So in that factory, if the production is about the ready-made shirts, suppose they are manufacturing ready-made shirts. So for that, okay, they have raw material, their cloth, whatever cloth is there, that is their raw material. But why cash in hand is required? So because some small parts are required. If the machines are not working or a needle is broken, they need to replace the needle. And then threads are required, buttons are required, packing material is required. Then a few advances to the labor, money has to be given, that is required. And petty expenses, they call it petty expenses, like for tea or any other goods which are required. So all this will be maintained through the cash in hand. So that's why they require money. Now, factors of production. Every production is organized by combining land, labor and physical capital and human capital is known as factors of production. So what are the factors of production here? Land, labor, physical capital, human capital. These are the four factors of production. So first one is like farming in Palampur. Land is fixed. Farming is the main production activity in the Palampur village. 75% of the people who are working are dependent on farming for their livelihood. They could be farmers or farm laborers. There is a basic constraint in raising farm production. So 75% of the village population is depending on the farming only for their livelihood. See, in that there may be the landowners also and the people who are working as laborers in those farms also, they are depending on this livelihood. There is a basic constraint in raising farm production. Land area under cultivation is practically fixed. Land area wherever they are growing, wherever they are sowing the seeds, agriculture is carried out, that land is always fixed. Since 1960 in Palampur, there has been no expansion in land area under cultivation. Since 1960, there was no expansion of the land for agriculture. Generally, nowadays we don't see expansion, but we are seeing the decrease of land area. Why? Because of the urbanization. because all the town cities are expanding. So while expanding, they are occupying the agricultural land and constructing buildings and roads and other things. So that's why nowadays we don't find much expansion. By then, some of the wastelands in the village have been cultivated, converted to cultivable land. But still, in this village Palampur, there was lot of change. Like some of the wastelands, they took it and made it into cultivable land and started growing small crops like vegetables and other things. There exists no further scope to increase farm production by bringing new land under cultivation. There was no further scope to bring more land for cultivation. Is there a way one can grow more from the same? Let us see about this. Palampur would resemble a village of the western part of the state of Uttar Pradesh. All land is cultivated in Palampur. No land is left idle. During the rainy season, Kharif, you know, it's a, we call it as one season of crops, we call Kharif. The other one will be Rabi. So, during Kharif season, farmers grow Jawar and Bajra. These plants are used as cattle feed, means they harvest the Bajra or Jawar, they take out the grains, that is we call millets, and then remaining the plants, they store it and use it for the cattle feed. It is followed by cultivation of potato between October and December. In the winter season, what we call as Rabi season, fields are sown with wheat. From the wheat produced, farmers keep enough wheat for the family's consumption and sell the surplus wheat at the market at Raiganj. So, when they grow wheat, after harvesting, whatever their requirement for the personal use, they keep it and then remaining, they sell in the market at Raiganj. A part of land area is also devoted to sugar cane, which is harvested once every year. Sugar cane is in its raw form or as jaggery is sold to traders in Shahpur. Now, in this slide, we saw so many things, so many activities of Palampur. What are they? See, about the seasons, Kharif, Rabi and in between also. What are the crops they are growing? Jawar, Bajra, wheat, sugar cane, potato and some of the vegetables. And then from sugar cane, they are selling it as raw sugar cane or they are taking out the sugar cane juice, boiling it and manufacturing jaggery. Jaggery and then they are selling it in the market. The Green Revolution in late 1960s introduced the Indian farmers to cultivation of wheat and rice using high yielding varieties of seeds. Compared to traditional seeds, the HYV seeds promised to produce much more greater amounts of grain on a single plant. As a result, the same piece of land would now produce for larger quantities of food grains that was possible earlier. See, during the 1960s, what the government of our country did is they gave more importance for the agricultural sector in the five-year plans. What they did, they brought a system or they brought a revolution and they called it as Green Revolution. What is this Green Revolution? In this Green Revolution, the government ensured to support the farmers and increase the productivity and increase the agricultural net sown area in the country by providing all the requirements, basic requirements to the farmers by giving them all the backup. backup here means by bringing cooperative societies, grameen banks, and then availability of the required seeds, and then availability of the required fertilizers in every district of the country. So in this way they brought lot of changes to help the farmers to increase the production, as because India is a very large populated country, so where we our needs or our wants are very high, so we must match with our production. That's why with lot of agricultural scientists doing lot of research, they could bring out a high yielding variety seeds. They could develop it. HYV seeds, what we call now in the market also, all the farmers buy HYV seeds, by which there is lot of increase in the production. That is, with the same piece of land, with the same crops, they are able to grow, they are able to harvest more quantity of the goods, that is food grains. Farmers of Punjab, Haryana and West Uttar Pradesh were the first to try the modern methods in India. The farmers in this region set up tube wells for irrigation, motors or tube wells what we call, using of electric motor and drawing the water and making the fields wet, and made use of HYV seeds, chemical fertilizers and pesticides in farming. Some of them bought farm machinery like tractors and threshers, which made plowing and harvesting faster. They were rewarded with high yields of wheat. So all these things they you see in this slide, we see modern farming methods. Even you find in your textbook also the same figure, where how they were using HYV seeds, they are using fertilizers, they are using pesticides to avoid the pest which will spoil the crops, then irrigational facilities from dams, pump sets, canals, they are arranging tube wells for watering of their crops, and then they are using machinery like tractors, threshers, and for plowing other things, and for this again they are using the fuel like diesel and petrol. Will the land sustain? What do you mean by sustain? Sustain means here, is the land having that much capacity for what we are forcing the soil to give us more production? So will the soil have its fertility retained after one crop, two crops, three crops? So for that reason we need to check, because sustainability means here coming up next generations also must utilize these resources. These resources, whatever is available today, we should not use it unnecessary. Additionally, we should not use it. What is our requirement? In a limited resource, we should consume, and remaining we should keep for coming generations. For example, a mango tree or a guava tree you have in your home. The tree is full of mangoes. Some might be raw, some might be ripe. So you start plucking it up. Today you want 10 mangoes, which you can consume around 8 to 10 mangoes. It doesn't mean that all the 400 mangoes you have to pluck and keep it at home. What happens? You are eating only 10 mangoes, remaining 390 mangoes. Tomorrow you may eat, another day you may eat. You may consume not more than say 100 mangoes. Remaining 300 mangoes will get perished. They get spoiled. They get rotten. So that's why how many you require, that many only if you pluck. The remaining will be on the tree and they will survive. Tomorrow you can pluck again. After 1 week also you can pluck again whenever you feel like eating mangoes. The same way the soil and the production also is like that, where we have to keep the sustainability. At a time, we should not use in a greedy manner. So now, land being a natural resource, it is necessary to be very careful in its use. Scientific reports indicate that modern farming methods have overused the natural resource base. Generally, in olden days, only organic farming was being taken. So what were the fertilizers used? They used to use the cow dung and all the natural things only. But now, by overusing the land continuously, we are doing farming. So the soil loses its all its minerals, nitrogenous salts and other things in the soil, and the production will decrease. So that's why what we are doing now, we are using chemical fertilizers, pesticides and other things to increase our production. But go on doing with that, the soil is losing fertility. In many areas, green revolution is associated with loss of soil fertility due to increased use of chemical fertilizers, also continuous use of groundwater for tubewell irrigation has reduced the water table below the ground. Here, just we were discussing, you overuse of chemical fertilizers. So continuously water is drawn from the underground. So what happens? Water gets exhausted, soil will lose its fertility. So that's why the government started again bringing out different initiatives in the 1980s. What they did? They started many agricultural labs, soil testing labs. So before a farmer sows the seeds, he should get his soil tested in the lab, where the agriculture scientists give a report where they say what is the content in the soil, what is required for the coming crop, how much quantity of fertilizers must be used. Overusage also is harmful. Less usage also is not good for the production. So all these factors are being checked by the government. Environmental resources like for soil fertility and groundwater are built over many years. Groundwater, it takes many years. All the rainwater has to settle down, it has to enter the earth's crust, and then water in the water table, water is formed. But we are destroying it in a very short period. So once destroyed, it is very difficult to restore them. Again, we have to wait. For example, now in our homes, if we have borewells, during summer it gets dried up. So we have to wait for one or two rains. Then only again water will come into your wells. So we need to carefully use the resources. We must take care of our environment to ensure future development of agriculture. So there are some four sources in yellow color boxes, in even in your textbook also. You need to go through those and learn the required things. Now, land distributed between the farmers of Palampur. You must have realized how important land is for farming. If there is no land, how can we do farming? Unfortunately, not at all people engaged in agriculture have sufficient land for cultivation. So everyone in the village do not have land for cultivation. In Palampur, about 1/3 of the 450 families are landless. 150 families do not have land. Most of them Dalits, scheduled caste, have no land for cultivation. More than half of the area of the village is covered by plots that are quite large in size in Palampur. There are 60 families of medium and large farmers who cultivate more than 2 hectares of land. A few of the large farmers have extending over 10 hectares or more, like Jamindar to middle class people. All are living in the village. See now, this is a straw house. Mud walls are made of straw and grass. thatched roof they have, and this is a pakka house. Now these are the major crop areas in our country. So what are the crops grown? And I tell request all the students, you do this map work, take a map and mark all this and learn these things. Next is, who will provide labor? After land, labor is the next necessary factor for production. Farming requires a great deal of hard work. Small farmers along with their families cultivate their own fields, thus they provide the labor required for farming themselves. Medium and large farmers hire farm laborers to work on their fields. Here see, the landowners who have small piece of land, that is 1 acre, 2 acres, what they do? They will work themselves. Their family only will get engaged in the work. They cannot hire or they can't afford to hire labor and pay them. Whereas the medium and the large farmers, those who have more bigger land, they hire laborers to work in their field whenever they require. The capital needed in the farming. The modern farming methods require a great deal of capital, so that the farmers now need more money than before. Capital means here, when they have to sow the crop, they need to buy the seeds, fertilizers, HYV seeds and other things. So for that they need money. Most small farmers have to borrow money to arrange for the capital. So they take loans either from formal or non-formal, informal. So here formal means like banks, cooperative societies, Grameen banks and other places. Informal means like what do we say, from the rich people, private people, known people, they have to give some security and take for higher rate of interest. Or village money lenders, we can say money lenders also. Or the traders supply various inputs for cultivation. That is, they buy the required things in credit by paying more cost. The rate of interest on such loans is very high. They are put to great distress to repay the loan. Sale of surplus farm products. The farmers have produced wheat on their land using the three factors of production. The wheat is harvested and production is complete. Farmers retain a part of wheat, as we discussed, whatever required for their personal use, for their home, for them to eat, then that they will retain for the family's consumption and sell the surplus wheat. The traders are at the market buy the wheat and sell it further to shopkeepers in the towns and the cities. Other large and medium farmers sell the surplus farm products. A part of the earnings is saved and kept for buying capital for the next season. So whatever the farmer gets the money, he will keep it for next season's buying the raw material or the seeds and other things for investing for the next crop. Thus they are able to arrange for the capital for farming from their old savings. Some farmers might also use savings to buy cattle, trucks or to set up any shops. That is, during off season they can go for some other activity, some other business. Now, non-farm activities in the Palampur. What do we have non-farm activities? See, first one is dairy, the other common activity. It's very common in the villages. What are those common activities? That is dairy activities. Dairy is a common activity in many families of Palampur because everyone will be having, they will be having cattle like cows, buffaloes, goats and other domestic animals. So here people feed their buffaloes on various kinds of grass and the jowar and bajra that grows during the rainy season. The milk is sold in Rai Ganj. So where they are selling to the bigger milk factories, but they will have the collection centers. So they are selling in Rai Ganj, which is 3 kilometers away from Palampur. Two traders from Shahpur town have set up collection cum chilling centers at Rai Ganj, from where the milk is transported to far away towns and cities. Chilling center means they will refrigerate. They will keep big refrigerated tanks in that all the milk is collected and then they will chill it and then they will pack it and again resell it to the far away towns and cities. Next one is transport. There are variety of vehicles on the road connecting to Palampur to Rai Ganj. Rikshawalas, tongawalas, jeep, tractor, truck drivers and people driving the traditional bullock cart and buggy are people in the transport services. Means here even these people also, they have chosen their profession as in the transport. They collect money. Now we find so many things. Now public transport, buses, autos and taxis, cabs, what we find in the towns and the cities. Like that, there also, if they have to go to the nearby village or town, they have to pay something and use these transport facilities available for them in the Palampur. So here, this is the summary of the lesson. And see, in a very simple way, in the summary, what we have learned, we will know. Farming is the main production activity in the village. Over the years, there have been many important changes in the way farming is practiced. These have allowed the farmers to produce more crops from the same amount of land. This is an important achievement since land is fixed and scarce. But in raising production, a great deal of pressure has been put on land and other natural resources. The new ways of farming needs less land but much more of capital. The medium and large farmers are able to use their own savings from production to arrange for capital during the next season. On the other hand, the farmers, small farmers who constitute about 80% of the total farmers in India, find it difficult to obtain capital because of the small size of their plots. Their production is not enough. Lack of surplus means that they are unable to obtain capital from their own savings and have to borrow. So in this chapter, we learned so many things by just studying one case study of a small village called Palampur. Here we studied how a village setup is there and which type of communities or people are there, and then how the caste, different castes and various levels of the people are living in what ways. Then what is the main activity in the village, like agriculture we studied, we understood that it is agriculture. Other than that, what are the food grains or what are the agriculture produce they are producing. So we saw so many types of grains, millets and other things, other crops also we learned about it. And then what is the requirement of the factors of production, like land we need, labor we need, physical activity, what physical factors we need, okay, like cash in hand, and then physical factors in it comes under that, then machine capital, labor, all these things, building infrastructure, all these come under physical factors. Like that we have learned all those things, and other activities which are being carried out in the village of Palampur. Some of them have small shops they have set up, and they are selling various types of requirements in the village, like say grocery shops, what we call as kirana shops, and then various types of business they have. Small village, even though it is having, but they are having all the types of business. Along with it, they have dairy farming, where they are producing milk and supplying it to Raiganj, where they are selling it, and then all the nearest market for them is Raiganj. And even with all these production, they are producing jaggery also. After growing sugarcane, they are manufacturing jaggery and they are selling it in the market. So to control or to take care of all the market activities, they need transportation. So transportation is also very active in this village. So in the name of village, we have learned so many things. Like if you start a factory, or if a production unit is started, what are the requirements needed? See, power is the main thing they require. Like we took the example of tube wells, how the farmers are using tube wells for better irrigational facilities. Like that, if you start a manufacturing unit, you need infrastructure. First land, then building, then machinery, then for production, raw material is required, labor is required. So then after the goods are ready, finished goods are ready, they need to take it to the market. So for that, they need transportation. So many things we have learned by taking one village as an example, as case study. We have taken one village as a case study. So I want you to read the textbook thoroughly, underline the important points given in the textbook, and prepare a small write-up about the village and what they are doing, and then you can go for the assignments and question answers. Thank you very much.